artistic director Smriti Kiran. Smriti, if we can welcome you.
Hi everyone, thank you first of all for coming out and making time for us. I think gratitude is always a good place to start with, so I'm going to begin by thanking the incredible number of partners that make this happen and have helped us build this space. I'm doing this on behalf of everybody sitting here and everybody on the board who's not present. I want to start with Jio, our title sponsors, who've supported us for the last 5 years, and I'm hoping they'll continue to do so. They deepen their engagement with us every year, and I can't say anything about this right now, but at our opening ceremony on the 17th, they have a few new initiatives that they're going to announce. Star India, who made the first call to us and came on board to support Mami in 2015 and have stood by us. The government of Maharashtra, for their unflinching support to us. Turkish Airlines, Mr. Gunte, Minas, thank you for joining us today. You've given us wings, and we are just so happy that you're on board because you've enabled travel all across the world for us and for our delegates to come here. I think TK-721 has almost become home, and I know the Istanbul airport more than the people working there. Large short films for making sure that we do not miss out on the gorgeous short films that have gained so much of momentum in India. PVR Cinemas for films, theatres, and for enabling the Academy's year-round programme. So thank you, Mr. Bijli. JW Marriott Juhu for being our home during the festival. GVK Pranam Services for setting the tone for the delegate experience in Mumbai for the festival. And Solomon & Co. for having our back on the legal front. Carnival and Regal Cinemas for giving us a South Mumbai footprint. Pentagon for making us look good on ground. Book My Show for ticketing and registration. Qwire for keeping us technically sound. Iris for keeping us piracy free. And finally, Blue Tokai for the coffee to keep us awake. I have a long list. I have a really long list of people to thank, but the names that I'm going to take now, this is the incredible Mami team that's been working tirelessly to make this festival happen, and they're actually the real warriors behind the lineup that is going to be unveiled for you. So I want to start by thanking Kalpana Nair, who heads program coordination for Mami. She's brilliant, and we wouldn't be able to do this without her. I also want to tell you that she brought us so much. I mean, there's so much of pride in her getting selected as a future leader by Screen International at the Cannes Film Festival. I want to also talk about Punita Gupta, Gavin Pinto, Richard Dhar, Shraddha Gulrajani, Sandeep Upadhyay, Rashmi Manuja, Gaurav Gupta, Kriti Dhanania, Disha Gadia, Komal Mithani, Risha Anant, Ankit Patel, Nikita Deshpande, Dhruvi Talreja, Monisha Day, Manoj Kumar, Dipanshu Parmar, Ankita Agarwal, Monish Chitnis, Govinda Ji and Ramesh Bhaiya for doing this for us. And of course, our curating team, Anuranga Char, the legendary Uma Dakuna, Rashid Irani, Deepti Dakuna, Mihir Fadnavis, Ashwati Gopalakrishnan, Ratish Radhakrishnan, Samina Mishra, Anu Singh Chaudhary for the Word to Screen Market, and Bharadwaj Rangan for Young Critics Lab. Now I'm going to get on to, getting on with unveiling the lineup, and therefore I'm going to invite Force of Nature and one of the most graceful and elegant people that I've met, Anupama Chopra, to do the needful.
SK, please don't embarrass me. Guys, thank you so much for coming. And really, gratitude is always the best place to start. I always say it takes a village to put together a film festival, and we are so, so grateful to have this amazing village that really helps, and to have an amazing leader like Smriti, who has put in, I can't even tell you what all, to give you this amazing lineup. So without further ado, let's have a look at the films you're going to see.
Premiered at the Berlin International Film Festival this year, and it was such an incredible experience. Global platforms like festivals can do so much for artists. The talent you get to meet with and connect with and the access you have to other industries is tremendous. To be part of the team that is building a space like this in our country is a serious privilege. This year we have brought together some of the most sought after artists and professionals from film industries across the world to weigh in on our competitive sections. I'm delighted to present the juries for two of our biggest sections, the India Gold Jury and the International Competitive Jury. For the India Gold Jury, Franklin Leonard is the head of jury, Christian Jun, Cole Needman, Gronia Humphreys. And the International Competitive Jury, Hani Abu Asad, head of jury, Julie Hunsinger, Mark Adams, Vetri Maran, and me.
Thank you so much, Zoya. Mr. Rohan Sippy.
Along with discovering new talent, one of our mandates here is to award incredible filmmakers who've inspired generations. In the last few years, we've awarded Amos Getai, Jia Zhangke, Darren Aronofsky, among many others. This year, we are very excited to announce that we're going to be honoring director Fernando Mireles, popularly known for his work on City of God, The Constant Gardener, with the Excellence in Cinema Award. He's also going to be introducing his latest film, The Two Popes, and there's also going to be a masterclass with him. I think we're all looking forward to meeting him, and thank you, very big thank you to Netflix for making this happen. Thanks.
Mr. Siddharth Roy Kapoor.
I second Rohan in awarding and honoring legacy, the fine artists who have shaped the narrative and brought us to where we are. This year, the Excellence in Cinema Award will go to the incredible and multifaceted actor, poet, and painter, the amazing Dipti Nawal. Whoa.
Mr. Ajay Bijli.
Afternoon, everyone. I'd like to thank Mami for once again having PVR associate itself with this very exciting, fun, and important festival. We've been building cinemas for a long time, but I believe that the cinema experience is just not complete if the content on the screen connects with the consumers, and that's what I think makes the whole experience complete. So it's we have lots of films anyway playing, but these 190 that have been carefully curated, selected, will play in our cinemas, and I'm really excited about that. And also we wear another hat of acquiring films. So we've got some good films, Pain and Glory, The Beach Bum, and also we're showing Asif Kabadia's Maradona on the 4th of October. So very excited to show films through PVR Pictures and also to exhibit films, these exciting films. And thanks once again for the association. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Vishal Bharadwaj.
The talent in India is so diverse that we have specially curated an out-of-competition section that showcases new and exciting work from both critically acclaimed and breakthrough Indian filmmakers. It is my pleasure to unveil this selection in a spotlight this year. In the last 10 days, we have also announced our lineup for India Gold and India Story sections to much applause. Let's have a look at the selections in these sections once again.
Anupama Chopra.
So I'm really, really proud of all the work that the Mami team has done and all these amazing films that you're going to see. I love everything about Mami, but this vertical has a special place in my heart because my first love is Hindi cinema. And the Mami Movie Mela celebrates Hindi cinema, Bollywood, I still call it that. Sorry to anybody who's offended. It's just a celebration of our passionate, you know, relationship with Hindi cinema, with the artists in Hindi cinema, with the stars, with the filmmakers. And I think I'm very excited that this year we're back with the Mami Movie Mela, and I hope lots of you will register and come.
Just a glimpse.
Yeah, just a glimpse of the Mela.
say that we are launching. This is something that we've been wanting to do for a very long time. But this year, starting from the festival, and of course, it'll have an imprint through the year, we are launching our industry program. I've spent the last year talking to a lot of industry professionals about what are their challenges and what would they like a space like JioMami with Star to do. And I think access and knowledge and being able to connect with the right people from within the industry is a challenge for a lot of people. So we are starting an industry program that is going to have very sharply curated small sessions with industry experts for filmmakers, writers, screenwriters. And the first glimpse of that you will see at this edition of the festival. Jio is actually also coming in to do a few curated sessions like that. We'll announce the lineup of those sessions, but these are B2B sessions for the industry. And now we open the house out for questions. So go for it.
Hi, this is Priyanka from Indian Express. My question is to Vishal and Zoya. Do you believe as filmmakers, festivals also, and especially like a platform like Mami, gives you also a reality check as to how stories and storytelling is evolving? Because a lot of times when we are, you know, into mainstream cinema, we kind of miss out on what's happening around us. So if you could share your thoughts on that.
I mean, I wouldn't call it a reality check. I'd call it a perspective. We are filmmakers, and we are storytellers, and we are that because first we are audience. We watch films, we like watching other people's work, we actually enjoy that process. So that is why we became filmmakers. I'm speaking for you,
Yeah.
I think so. I think that's why we became filmmakers. So yeah, we enjoy the process. I wouldn't term it the way you did though.
Can I ask my question?
Yeah. I think Zoya said everything. Yeah, because, you know, when you watch a good film, it makes you envious and it gives you energy to work more on yourself. So it's a great, and to watch the films on big screen is a different, like Roma when we watched last year. And then again, I watched it on Netflix. The experience was completely different. And yeah, Ajay, thanks for that.
Yeah, so the question that I'm Sangeeta Wadhwani from Hello Magazine, the executive editor. One of the very interesting trends that one has observed in Indian cinema now is the more edgier and the more risk-taking you are as a person selecting a subject as a way of depicting character, gender meltdown. A lot of Zoya's films have been interesting that way because the women are now actually walking away from the institution of marriage. So there's a lot of questioning that's going on in our storylines. Would you say that actually, from a commercial perspective, taking a risk today is more relevant to our audiences than staying with any kind of formula?
I don't think there's any rule. I don't think that there's any, if you, you know, you can't approach something as like, I'm going to do something different, or I'm going to do something that hasn't been done before. I think that's a sure recipe for disaster, if that's your intent. I think what you have to do is take a story that has moved you in some way, and what it made you feel, put that out there and transmit that in the most honest way possible. So sometimes those stories are not things that are part of the mainstream or have been part of the mainstream narrative. And I think today, with more screens, with more platforms, with a changing palette because of the access that we have, I think the audience is open to that. I think the audience is open to self-reflection and it's open to honesty. So a combination of all that, I think, has helped newer stories to come out. And that's it. But I don't think you need to go in with that kind of intention.
Hi, my question is to Smriti. So every year, you know, there's a lot of excitement for the India Gold and associated sidebars, and we did see beautiful glimpses of the films that's coming up. If you could shed more light on, you know, the curation process for the various Indian films you're going to see, and maybe point out specific films you're excited about. We know about Gitanjali Rao's film. There's a lot of excitement. Gurvinder Singh's films coming. Other directors you want festival goers to look out for? Yeah.
So, you know, you'll have the whole lineup with you for sure. Right. And like you can't choose between your babies, I cannot choose between the films that we are programming, but they're amazing films. In all three sections that deal with Indian films. I think the curation process, like everybody says, is a dark art. I think the idea is to basically make Mami a discovery platform for exactly the kind of narratives that are coming out and how you know, new filmmakers are changing the game. And I think that is what we look for in films. We also, in India Story, I think the curation process is slightly different because India Story is not a competitive section. And India has 22 official languages and it has many film cultures. So I think there, apart from quality, we also look at diversity. So that, you know, there is a voice that different film cultures can have at a platform like Mami.
Hi, my question is for Zoya. Here, hi. Congratulations on Gully Boy going to the Oscars. So I just, you've gone on record to say that films no longer need, filmmakers no longer need to bank on big stars, big names, you know, for their films to work. It's all in the storyline. Let's say your Gully Boy didn't have Ranveer Singh and an Alia Bhatt in leading roles. Do you think it would have still got the response that it did?
I really can't see the future, or, you know, I don't know. Like, that's the only answer I know, is that I don't know. But having said that, I don't mean that you don't need actors or you don't need stars or you don't need anything. It really depends on what you're doing, what you're telling, what your budget is, who you're selling to, where do they fit in. I think any story, whether it's big budget, small budget, with stars, without stars, needs a strong idea or a strong story. Right. Today, it's not just about stars. You don't need a camera. You can make a film on a phone. I mean, the whole game's changed.
Right.
It's not just about stars anymore.
Sure. Thank you.
Hi. My question is to Smriti and Anupama. Could you tell us a little bit about Netflix's connection with Mami this year? We saw a glimpse of The Irishman. So like last year, are you going to show as many titles of theirs on the big screen as possible?
We programmed 6 titles from Netflix. All titles we asked for, they gave us. So thank you, Netflix. The connection is that they make really good films, and we want all of them, and they were kind enough to give that to us. There's 6 of them. One is also in competition, which is Atlantics. I should not have said that. I think Kalpana is very unhappy because we've not dropped the international competition section, but that's the Mati Diop film. And they've also managed to, we always, whenever we work with studios or production houses, we are constantly trying to get talent to India for masterclasses, for interactions with filmmakers here, the community here. And they've also organized Fernando to come here and introduce his film and also do a special masterclass with Anupama.
Hello, my name is Shalki and I'm from the Asian Age newspaper. And my question is for you guys as filmmakers, we tend to notice that Mami has, you know, the curation is quite experimental in nature, be it narrative or be it the stories or the execution of it. So do you guys also see that popular cinema, maybe we need to incorporate more experimentation in for you know, general audience, because filmmakers and cinephiles do really enjoy breaking away from certain patterns.
No, you know, I think it's a really interesting time in our cinema now where you have, within the span of 3 months, a Ranveer Singh can do a Simba and then he can do a Gully Boy. I don't think we've ever seen a time like that in our cinema where an actor gets those sort of opportunities. Our audience is getting the sort of opportunities to be able to watch such a diverse palette of cinema. And I think what festivals do is they give us an opportunity to be able to watch films that we probably would not have had the chance to watch otherwise, and to just expand our horizons. I mean, for an audience, it's just a chance to watch great movies. For filmmakers, it's a chance to watch the best of cinema from around the world and maybe learn new ideas or just enjoy, you know, movies that they would not have otherwise seen. But I think it's a really interesting time in Indian cinema today where it's not about limiting or moving away from what we were earlier. It's about expanding the palate of the audience, where they can enjoy, like I said, a Simba and a Gully Boy with the same star, and they both go on to do exceptional business. And that's very exciting, I think.
Hi, this is Srishti from News 18. My question's to all of you. What do you have to say about, you know, mainstream actors and films taking over the film festivals, which are primarily, you know, meant for independent filmmakers and films which often has hard time finding distributors and financiers? What's your take?
But have they?
Sorry?
Have they taken over? Has the mainstream taken over?
Nowadays we see a lot of mainstream actors, you know.
Can I just say that I find these divisions now, I think they're a little archaic. As he said, when you can do Gully Boy and Simba, and Tumbad is as much a Hindi movie as Simba is, as anything else is. I don't think we operate, and I've been around long enough to know the time when we did operate from those divisions. You know, when it was very obvious who art house was and who commercial was, but I really don't think we operate in those paradigms anymore. So I'm not sure who is a mainstream actor as opposed to who is not. I mean, who's Pankaj Tripathi? Is he mainstream? Is he art house? What is he? Who's Nawaz? Zoya, who are you? So I think, I'm addressing it because I think that I was the one always accused of bringing too much Bollywood into the festival, because as I said, my heart belongs to Bollywood. But I genuinely don't think those divisions exist. And I think that if we can use the power of these artists to pull in eyeballs to other films that perhaps don't have that same level of distribution or eyeballs, we would have done something good. I think if we don't leverage the power of Hindi cinema when we're a festival in Mumbai, then we would be quite stupid and ignorant.
Hello everyone. I'm Upma from Navbharat Times. My question is to everyone. First, Zoya, I hope you get an Oscar for Gully Boy. I hope we get an Oscar this time. I hope. So, अभी तक की जैसे ऑस्कर हमें नहीं मिला, कांस के भी कॉम्पिटेटिव सेक्शन में हमारी फिल्में उतनी नहीं पहुंच पाती जितना हम होना चाहिए या हम उम्मीद करते हैं. आप लोग इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे हमारे सिनेमा को कहाँ पाते हैं? सभी से सवाल है.
I think it's one of our mandates. It's unfortunate that films like Court and films like Newton and a lot of other films that could have been in competitive sections at festivals outside have been programmed out of competition. These are fantastic films. We've got some fantastic filmmakers like Gurvinder and like Amit Masurkar. And they should have been programmed in competition, but I don't know why they weren't programmed in competition. I think one of the mandates, like as an academy, we've taken it upon ourselves that one of the things that JioMami also does is, you know, foster relationships with a lot of festivals to make sure that talent, Indian talent, not only gets pride of place, but also gets discovered. Because sometimes what happens is there's only 5 creators or 10 creators from India that people in the West know about. You know, India is almost like Europe. You've got 22 languages, you've got so much talent across the board. You've got so many films getting made that, you know, when they program from Asia as a whole. So India gets maybe 2 spots, if at all. So I think we are also working towards it, and I think they're also getting aware as creators travel there. But you're right, there are films that were deserving that were not programmed the way they should have been programmed outside. But hopefully we'll change that.
Vishal sir, aapko jodna chahenge, please.
आई थिंक बहुत अच्छा है. अब लंच बॉक्स के नाम से तो हम लोग जाने जाते हैं यहाँ पे. न्यूटन और दूसरी फिल्म कौन सा नाम लिया था? कोर्ट कितनी अप्रिशिएट हुई है बाहर भी. तो आई थिंक जब तक हम अपनी स्टोरीज नहीं कहना शुरू करेंगे तब तक हम इंटरनेशनल में नहीं पहुँच सकते हैं. अगर हम चाहेंगे कि हम इंटरनेशनल फिल्मों से कॉम्पिटिशन करें तो हमें अपनी कहानियाँ कहनी ज़रूरी हैं. जैसे कोर्ट हमारी अपनी कहानी थी कि हाउ डज अ कोर्ट वर्क इन इंडिया. And I think we should make a film about how does the censor board work in India. Yeah. That will be a, you know, will make a mark.
आज हमारे बीच लेजेंडरी एक्टर विजय कोते नहीं रहे तो क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप सभी से क्वेश्चन? विजय कोते लेजेंडरी एक्टर जो थे आज हमारे बीच नहीं रहे हैं तो क्या कहना चाहेंगे उनके बारे में, क्या रिएक्शन?
Mr. Vijay Kote passed away today, and yeah, and I mean, he's been around. I've seen him in films since I was a child. He's been part of Sholay, and I mean, he's a face that's been in everyone's consciousness, whoever watches Indian cinema, and we would hope that he rests in peace and give the best wishes to his family and send them strength and energy at this point, I think, yeah.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your questions. Before we break for one-on-ones, we'd like to have the jury together for a picture.